Good day to you. Hey, I've been in a coffee shop, camped out, reading. I wanted to share something more meaningful than a survey on like whether or not you like pumpkin pie or ham or turkey, all those things that I've been posting recently. Thanks for checking those out. Well, look, check this out. Matthew 20, Jesus teaches a parable, and the parables were ways to help us better understand something that was hard to understand about God. And one of the parables is the parable of the vineyard workers, where you have a landowner. He hires a group of people to work, let's say for an 8-hour day. They agree to a wage, but then throughout the day, he hires more people to work. Some of them worked 5 hours, some of them worked 4, some of them got 3, some of them worked 1. Then at the end of the day, they punch the time card, they all come in to get paid, and they all, because the landowner is the landowner, he pays them all the same wage. The first amount agreed to, whether they worked 8 hours or 1 hour. Now here's the kicker. In this parable, in verses 9, 10, 11, and 12, the people who were hired at first have a problem that they put in an 8 hours day and they're getting paid the same amount for the people who got hired at the end of the day. Verse 9, then those who were hired about 5 came and they each received 1 denarius. So when the first ones came, the guys originally hired, they assumed they would get more, but they also received a denarius each, which is what they agreed to. While they received it, they began to complain to the landowner. These last men put in 1 hour and you made them equal to us who bore the burden of the day's work in the burning heat. And he replied to one of them, friend, I'm doing you no wrong. Didn't you agree with me on 1 denarius? Take what's yours and go. I want to give this last man the same as I gave you. Don't I have the right to do with what I want, with what is mine? Are you jealous because I'm generous? So the last will be first, and the first will be last. Well, just a real quick couple observations. One is, we're not the landowner. In this passage, this is God. And listen, we can't comprehend God's grace. We're all in need of it. Romans tells us we're all sinners. We have all missed God's measuring stick. We have all missed the mark. And we need what Jesus has done for us on the cross. We're all in need of that. We're not the landowner. Also, Scripture tells us man's ways and God's ways are not the same. We cannot comprehend the grace of God. We cannot comprehend being a creation. We cannot comprehend the Creator. It's beyond our mindset. And then the last thing is this. The one verse that caught me this morning is verse 12. These last men put in 1 hour, and you made them our equal. And we bore the burden of the day's work in the burning heat. That's dangerous ground for you and I. And it's not common ground with what we read about in Scriptures when we start looking at people and considering them not our equal. Whether it's because of what they've done in the past, whether it's what they've done last weekend, whether it's their skin color, whether it's their income, whether it's their nationality or what language they speak, it is easy to fall into that trap when you look at somebody else and they're not going to measure up. Dangerous ground, especially, you know, if we're claiming to be Christians, we're all in the same boat. We're all in need of grace and God's forgiveness that we find through faith in Jesus Christ and what he did on the cross for us. This week, I hope you offer that grace. Somebody in traffic, somebody in the Walmart line, somebody that you're working next to, maybe somebody in your living room or at the dinner table, that you're able to offer that grace and that hope and encouragement that we find in ourselves and that we desire from God, that we're able to offer that to other people as well. Hope you have a great week. And I hope you find encouragement because of what Jesus has done for us.